Are you scrolling through social media, seeing those jaw-dropping celestial images and thinking, I want to do that? If you just try to search for the best astrophotography telescope for beginners, only to be bombarded with endless choices, you're not alone. Many astrophotographers have felt the overwhelming frustration of not knowing where to begin. Hi, I'm Tim from Cosmic Captures, and in this video, I will help you navigate your first steps into the amazing world of astrophotography. Diving into astrophotography can indeed seem quite intimidating initially. Since my teenage years, I dipped my toes into visual astronomy a few times, learning the basics of how telescopes operate. While this gave me a bit of a head start, it only partially prepared me for the intricacies of astrophotography. I quickly discovered it's a field with a whole new level of complexity. One of the first things I had to learn is that astrophotography isn't just one thing, but a multitude of different genres, each with its unique requirements and challenges. And I've learned, sometimes the hard way, that not understanding what you want to capture can cause a ton of headaches and lead to buying gear that doesn't match your interests. But you don't have to make these mistakes when you understand the basics. So let's start right there. Every single astrophotography setup consists of three main items: the optics, the camera, and the mount. While the optics and the camera should match the type of astrophotography you want to do, they only work if they have a solid foundation in the form of a telescope mount. And that mount is like the heart of your setup. It keeps everything moving and has the critical task of compensating for the rotation of the Earth. The mount has to be very precise and solid enough to securely carry your telescope and camera. But not only that, for astrophotography, the stability demands are much higher than for visual observations. Now that we are aware that the mount, the optics, and the camera need to harmonize, let's explore the fact that there are several unique types of astrophotography. Let's start with nightscape photography. This type of astrophotography combines night sky elements with landscapes. Often it's the Milky Way or star trails paired with a striking terrestrial foreground. If you're interested in this type of astrophotography, a telescope may not even be your primary need. Instead, a good camera, a wide-angle lens, on a quality tripod might be the right choice. And once you've gathered more experience, you can upgrade and add a star tracker, which can boost the quality of your images tremendously. And then we have deep sky photography, where we capture objects outside of our solar system, like nebulae, galaxies, and star clusters. When you start with this type of astrophotography, capturing wider fields of view, like large and bright nebulae, or, for example, the Andromeda galaxy, is the way to go. In the beginning, short focal length optics are much more forgiving, and with them you can learn the basics of the craft much quicker. In its most basic form, you can do that with a star tracker on a sturdy tripod, an interchangeable lens camera, and a telephoto lens. But when you progress, you might want to capture objects that are more challenging and often dimmer, and that requires long exposure times. To reveal the details of these faint objects, we use telescopes that gather light quickly, specialized filters, and cooled astro cameras. The goal is to collect as many photons as possible, and we do that by taking many several minute long exposures, collecting light often for several hours. During that time, we have to keep the exact same part of the sky in the frame, which puts enormous demands on the telescope mount. Things can get quite complex, and you want to avoid that when you're starting out. If you're more drawn to the moon or the planets, perhaps lunar and planetary photography might be for you. Contrary to deep sky photography, we have to use long focal length telescopes that give us a much higher magnification. And we need that because the planets appear tiny in the sky. Small craters and features on the moon also need a lot of magnification power. The good thing is that the moon and the planets are bright, and we can use that to our advantage. With the help of high frame rate planetary cameras, we can use the lucky imaging technique to record the finest details and reduce the effect of atmospheric turbulence. Instead of capturing single images, we record video sequences and then use software to select and stack the frames with the sharpest details into one high-quality image. Since most astrophotography happens at night, we sometimes completely forget solar photography. But that's a shame, because it's one of the most dynamic types of astrophotography and a fantastic way to explore our life-giving sun. Solar photography always requires specialized filters to protect the camera sensor and, most importantly, our eyes from the intense sunlight. With a simple white light filter, you can safely image the sun's photosphere with its bright granules of plasma and the darker, cooler sunspots. And with an H-alpha filter, it gets really exciting, because you can take fascinating images of the sun's chromosphere with its solar flares and prominences. These features change over the course of minutes, making this special type of photography so dynamic. But remember, safety first. Always use proper solar filtration to protect the camera sensor. And never ever look directly into the sun with unprotected eyes. There's also a number of even more exotic types of astrophotography. They cover more unusual subjects and techniques, like capturing the aurora or the International Space Station transiting the sun or the moon. Another branch of specialized astrophotography is comet hunting, and you can track and image minor planets. Then there's also spectroscopy, where we can study the colors of light emitted or absorbed by objects in space. And by analyzing these colors, we can learn a lot about these objects. These special types of astrophotography demand precise planning and timing. And for aurora, and especially comet hunting, you need quite a bit of luck too. Astrophotography is a fantastic and very gratifying hobby. When I took my first astro image, I was completely hooked. And that's a moment I will never forget. The thing is, the journey to that moment did start much earlier, by learning about the fundamentals of astrophotography. I understand, you might be bubbling with excitement to kickstart your astrophotography journey straight away. If you've been with me to this point in the video, in a way, you already have. And that's because, at its core, astrophotography is all about learning and discovery. Understanding the distinct aspects of different astrophotography types is your first step into a more enjoyable journey. It will help you avoid needless frustration and expense. If you're feeling in the slightest bit swamped, step back and invest more time in learning and researching astrophotography gear. It will pay off. And don't worry, I've got more insightful content on the way. In upcoming videos, I'll dive into the specific gear suited to each type of astrophotography. And finally, before you head off, I'm curious, which type of astrophotography are you most excited about? Drop a comment below, hit the like button if you found the video helpful, and do subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for tuning in, and clear skies till we meet again. Thank you.